The Onion News Network.
Welcome to the Rebel Love Show. We are a once-a-week podcast from Manchester, where we are pro-pots, pro-gun, and pro-coffee. You can find all of our comments at rebellovshow.com. I am Ram Mathias.
And I am the Rebel Mistress. Do we have a sneeze button? I'm about to sneeze.
No. Yeah.
Okay. Do that, wait, hold on. No, I think I'm good. Okay. Today in studio, we have a
Hi, everyone.
Do you want to introduce yourself?
Yep, this is Allie Havens.
Oh, nice to meet you. The one and only. Is this your first time on the show or no? You've been on before.
I have been on the show one other time.
I didn't listen to that show. I remember I was sleeping.
Were you sleeping that
day? Yeah, I slept that day. I was like,
were you at
you weren't on the show or you didn't do it?
I was at the studio when you were there.
Yeah.
Rebel Love Pad. And I took a nap.
How far we've come, by the way.
Yeah. I was like napping.
The studio is awesome, by the way.
Oh, much better than before.
I'm taking away the studio.
I like how it's all enclosed. And bright.
My thing with the studio, first off, if you're listening to LRN, rebelloveshow.com/live, you can actually watch our studio cam. But yeah, the walls, I really wish they were like at least like 2 feet back farther. Like just two, it's a little too much.
It'd be easier for the green screen.
Yeah.
But I give us credit because this room was completely pink. But
when it was all pink when we moved into this studio.
So it's a
this
fun is thing.
This was one weekend project. I can't believe we got it actually all done in a weekend. I thought it'd take
it looks
a lot
amazing.
Longer. Yeah.
Hey, you had help. I handed you nails.
The only thing I miss, you know what I miss from, you know what I miss in the studio though?
What?
I really miss.
Are you gonna say that goddamn couch?
The casting couch?
Is that what you're gonna say?
Yeah.
The casting couch.
The casting. She made it past the casting couch.
Oh my god. You remember that ugly leather futon he had?
When you say couch, what is it like?
Okay,
do I have a dirty mind for thinking of porn?
No, or is that what you're the casting referencing? Couch is a dirty futon in which women come for prospective jobs and they're cast.
Well, who said porn jobs?
Well, any job that you can, any producer who would like to sleep with the talent. And so he had this like black casting couch.
You can perform any talent as long as you can do it on this couch.
No, any sexual talent. And a lot of sexual talents were performed on that couch. So I got rid of it.
I'm glad I didn't audition to be on the Rebel Love Show.
She had the best sexual audition on that casting couch.
Anyway, the casting couch is gone. I gave it away for free.
I know. I was so upset, too. Oh, my God, when she did.
I was like, who wants a couch?
Like, yeah, as soon as I was like, yeah, okay. She didn't wait like a second or like 5 minutes or like even like a day. Like literally got on her phone and was like, I'm going to post it right now. It's for free so we can come and get it. And you know what happened? You know what happened as soon as she did that? We didn't get the place to live. And we spent like another month without a couch.
No couch.
Couch.
I didn't care. It was worth it.
No.
We didn't even, that couch was horrible. Anyway, so while we're reminiscing, did anyone have anything interesting happen this weekend? Allie, I know you just moved back to the Shire.
I just moved back.
So, I mean, I feel like maybe when you go away, you disappear. Kind of like if you don't upload your videos on YouTube, they don't exist anymore. So, what were you doing pre your move?
So,
what kind of podcast did you do? Where are you from? Whole backstory. Yeah, and then you can go into your weekend. And then you can go into your weekend.
I can tell you about my weekend. Okay. So, who am I? That's a good question. As far as podcasts I've done, I've my first real like long-term podcasting gig was doing Ladies and Keen, and that's pretty old school. And let's see, I did ALP, and I also co-hosted Free Talk Live and Adam vs. The Man Show. So that's my podcasting resume. And I was in the Shire previously, and then had a little hiatus in Auburn, Alabama for about 6 months. And I'm back as of like a few weeks ago.
So your activism here was podcasting, you'd say. Yeah. But I know for a fact you're a Robin Hooder too, right?
I wouldn't. I just know that some people did that almost every day. Some mm-hmm. people did that as like a real job, so I wouldn't call myself a Robin Hood or like. But you did. I think that, I like have done it once or twice. So in that sense, like yes, I'm like one of the Robin Hooders. I am a Robin Hooder. I am Robin Hood. But I wouldn't. Yeah, I wouldn't like yeah. say that I did it as often as the people who really like made it a commitment.
Okay, I feel you. So. You just would say like your main thing you did here is podcasting. Was there any other kind of activism that you got into or were interested in getting into?
I would try to, when I lived in Keene, there was a lot of, courtroom activism, I guess, as far as just a lot of times it would just be, all that would be asked is that you just show up to watch people when they're in court and support them and be there for them in spirit and everything. And I would try to do some of that. Although I was listening to y'all's previous show mm-hmm. and you're talking about how you hate being board meetings and stuff. I'm the same way about there. Being in court.
Yeah.
So I really hate doing anything court yeah. related.
Court, government, anything office. Like,
I love the idea of supporting mm-mm. people, but I really am self-interested about staying out of court. That's why I try not to get arrested. Yeah. That's probably why my activism is podcasting and doing this TV. I did freaking TV back in the day.
I actually used to watch that.
Really?
Yes,
I would love to do something
it was like
that.
Thing. You guys used like sit like front of a desk and like talk about the news
professional.
Of the Shire. Yeah.
That's still on YouTube because I watched some videos with Allie.
We were looking through them. That was a really fun time.
So if you guys want to see those videos.
I think they're selling like Freeman TV or something like that.
I think you look really professional and young. Like not that you look young now, but you look extra.
Whenever I see myself in videos, I'm always mortified. You guys have that?
Yes.
Also listening back to my voice.
No, just that and like, I can't stand listening to my voice. Try doing a show all the time and editing
with your
it.
Voice, I could understand, but I mean,
yeah,
even
I
have
horrible.
This.
No, I'm just cocky. I like audiobooks because I like people listening to my voice. Listen. And I love watching myself on camera. I've been in theater for years. Like, I can do this. Is my thing. Like, that's what I do.
The only thing, I don't know about you. Have you noticed, like, how different you look just from, like, a couple years ago? Do you think that? Because you said, like, you're looking back, like, older stuff. Do you, like, think, yes, you look really young compared to now? Or why do you...
No, it's just, it's like, I would be equally as embarrassed if I did it yesterday, except that there are some things, like, for instance, this might be applied to... I don't want to say it applies to girls more than guys. Definitely the makeup thing, like having different styles of that kind of thing and looking back and being like, oh my God, my eyebrows back then. What was I thinking?
Yeah, no.
I constantly have that. But then I think guys can relate with like hair and clothes.
No, guys can't relate with anything.
We can relate.
What do you relate to? What's different for you?
You know what's different for me? Now in the cold, I don't have to put my hands up to keep you warm.
What?
In video. Like embarrassing video.
Okay, that's me because I change my hair all the time.
You said what's different for me. That's different for me. I don't have to do that anymore.
Shut up. I change my hair all the time, so it's really, really drastic when I look back at pictures. Because if I look back even 6 months ago, I shaved my head. Like,
oh shit.
Yeah, I shaved it like the whole back part, and I just had like a strip of blue in the front and just like a shaved head, and Robbie put his hands up to my head. And that was just like 6 months ago. And then you move up and like I think I kept my hair blue for a while.
My hair got shorter and my beard got longer and your hair got longer.
Yeah. And then
it's like it went the opposite.
And then
direction.
I got extensions and dyed it blonde and I don't know. No, I got extensions and it was black for a while. Then it was blonde. So like looking at pictures, like it feels like it's been even if it's only been like a couple months for me. But again, I don't get nervous when I look at myself. I'm
like, love
yeah.
going back every once in a while.
Go me. Damn.
Look like.
I look good.
I
got to
aim.
I got to try harder in a few months.
I need to aspire to be more like you.
That's okay. It'll rub off.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
It usually does. So now, down to your weekend. What
did I do this weekend?
You got to adventure its weekend.
I'm totally blanking on...
Does that mean it was good? Because you're
I think that means it was good.
I have a hard time remembering.
I've been playing a lot of video
we
games
all went
lately.
To Keene is what we did. I'll start it off.
Oh, that's right.
Thank you.
There was a party that the people of honor were barely even there when we got there.
No, they weren't even there.
No, Pete was there. He was walking out as we like walked.
It's so funny. Well, going into break. Talking about old celebritarians. And when we come back, we'll talk about how Allie is one.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people?
Yeah, we're live on YouTube, so.
Live on YouTube.
Yeah. Hey, when you,
People in the LRN chat can't hear us, can they?
Yeah, if they're watching live on YouTube, yes, they can.
Live on YouTube? Whoa.
Yeah, I actually posted the link in the chat.
So when you guys talk about chat, are you talking about LRN?
Yes.
Yeah, it's on the Revolution.
Speaking of Allie, can you like face this way or move the mic just a little bit more that way? No, it can be near you. Just move it that way so it's like completely. There you go. Perfection.
But then I can't. What if I want to talk to Anne?
Okay, that's fine. Just do it like. There you go. Beautiful. Okay.
Do this right now. I wanted to be around people like me who got it, and once I got here. I knew there was
so
no
you raved a lot, huh?
Yeah, when are we gonna go?
I love that it appears
that way. Gonna go to a rave.
We need to go to one.
Yeah.
Well, we're gonna go.
Festivals. It's like they all happen over on the West Coast now, or maybe that's just because. Just wanted to come to sort of. Oh my god, this ad. I fucking hate it.
Why?
It's like that thing we were talking about, except this one plays over and over and over. And I was nervous when I was taking it the first time.
Shire is awesome.
I had to do like a bunch of takes, and then Ian and Mark are like getting mad at each other because they weren't able to get the kind of sound bite that they wanted out of it. And then they took that one, which I never even liked, and then just plays over and over, and people make fun of it, and I can see why they hate it, and I hate it too.
I can't lie. I make fun of it.
Catchy.
Pretty often.
It's catchy, though.
Yeah.
Awesome, loving, and positive. That's not even how it sounds. It sounds like breathier and blah.
You should just, like, patent, like, that phrase.
Well, that's what how ALP got its name.
Oh, here you go. Another one of your commercials for you. Just all these are just Allie commercials.
I know,
on
Allie Havens, the voice of liberty.
Awesome. It's about demonstrating to the entire country. The voice of liberty.
Yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
I should really have a megaphone. I'm gonna be the voice of liberty. It's
the world's largest. Okay, you're trying to bring it back, FYI.
No problem.
And it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing. To be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the free project is
made. So weird.
Oh, here it is. Let me go back to the chat. Let's go, man. Feeds.
There's a lot of thinking about it, talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire. Documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
I blame my shitty laptop.
Wait, Randall.
You get news updates about what's happening on the radio network delivered in the way you prefer. You can sign up for our email.
Wait, I didn't hit broadcast.
At least I can back it up. You can stay in the
loop by joining our Facebook. There we go.
Rob, get your shit together.
Oops. Twitter.lrn.lrn.fm.
It's all free. So sign up now at updates.lrn.fm for news updates delivered to your email box. Facebook.lrn.fm to follow our Facebook page. And Twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets.
In Survivor Max 2, School Bites, Maximus scavenged through a wasteland swarming with the undead. Desperate to find the medicine he needs.
Kickstarter said, hey, Allie.
Yeah, because I said hi to him.
Oh, where did you say that?
I guess I don't really know Kickstarter's gender.
Oh, you're Anarcho Allie. Okay.
That's me.
Read chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We're here with Allie Havens, who's telling us a little bit about her history. She's done a lot. I think one of the things that stuck out most to me was probably Adam versus the Man, because someone who I met this summer at Porkfest, you know, you meet a lot of awesome, awesome people at Porkfest. Like,
so true.
You could just be walking down the street and just meet someone who's just so inspirational and changes your life, maybe. And this summer I met someone who Rob has known forever.
Yeah, I've known Murdoch for about 3 years before I
And you guys were just in love on Facebook or what was
going
on?
Well, no, we when I started getting like into like the whole Liberty world and stuff like that, people friend bomb me. You know, you add people that you're talking to in groups and stuff like that, and you just start adding people. And
is that how it goes down?
I don't know. That's how it went down with me.
Rob is a social butterfly.
I'll send them a friend request. I don't care if I actually haven't met them in person or not.
He'll talk to anybody. You know? Even like people who I'm like, Rob, that person is like a little iffy. You know, like the shady people, their name, they'll be like some foreigner and they only have like one picture and it's of like an eye. And then they seem normal. And then they start posting things like, you know, about like radical.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about your friend who was like, all women are important, but especially Indian women. Because
that person was an Indian, and
she said no other women.
English. I don't know how she ended up on my friends list.
But she had wrote you before, and you just talked to her, and I'm like, this lady is obviously crazy.
Oh, she wanted to see if I could record a music video for her sister that lived in Canada, not knowing how far away I am from Montreal or something like that.
Wow.
Yeah. And I don't know. I was still talking to her. I'm like, yeah, see, I don't do producing work.
This is my point. He will talk to anyone past this point. Like you or me, if we seen something that was like a little strange, like we're just going through Facebook, la, 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 la. Some like person writes you like this kind of thing. And like, it's nice to talk to them. But she was like so blatantly, she started being very racist, like in like this debate thread. And I was just like,
I'm making an I don't like racist people face.
Yeah. I'm like, I was just like, Rob. Like,
oh, I gave her the boot.
And he had to like kick her off the Facebook page because she just like started going crazy with like weird. This like hate.
Pro-Indian.
Racist against.
She's pro-Indian. She thought Indians were a
superior race.
Master race over everyone
and
else.
And every other woman just like wasn't
as
far.
Yeah.
But
it was really bizarre. Anyways,
it was really bizarre.
To transition back, Murdoch Biscotti of Come and Take It Texas and don'tcomply.com.
Someone who is not crazy, like all the other people he
plays. Yeah, he's a cool guy. he camped with us during Pork Fest and whatnot. He even helped me out when I proposed. He helped me propose.
He held the ring.
Yeah,
right?
He hid the ring. Oh. He hid the ring so that she couldn't find it in my campsite.
It's so funny because I actually drove off with
the responsibility,
in the car,
right?
And didn't even know.
So, anywho, oh yeah, that's right. Oh my God, you did drive into town with it.
With the ring, I didn't even know it was in the car. But Murdoch was a great guy.
The same day too. The same day I was gonna propose, we're like freaking out, like no.
Yeah, Murdoch was a good guy. It's always 50-50 with like random people that you meet on Facebook, but like they had just met, and he was just fit in right away, and he was just this guy who was like down for anything. He's like, let's just have the most amount of fun, and those are the kind of people that we like to be around. And he does some awesome activism. He actually was giving a speech. Did he ghost print the bottom half of a receipt? Like, what did he do at Porkfest with the ghost gunner?
Murdoch Biscotti, back in February or something like that, he had Cody Wilson's very first ghost gunner.
I don't know what that is.
A ghost gunner is a miller that will mill a lower receiver. So a mill is like a drill goes down. It's think of a 3D printer, but it's not actually a 3D printer. It's a miller because it's a drill. It's taking away, not adding. But it basically used a computer program. You hook that up. It's like literally a printer that goes on your desk and it prints a lower receiver without a serial number for an assault rifle.
Oh,
yeah. Okay. So that's what I basically I couldn't explain
that.
That
was Cody Wilson's
guns.
Original one. He had on he literally made firearms on like the state house in Texas. Cool. And he did his talk at Pork Fest, and like he shipped that to us, and then we took that up to Pork Fest with him and stuff like that.
Yeah. So he is on don'tcomply.com, and he was talking to us about, you know, how his website was just starting up, and he went home.
No, he's been doing that site for a while.
But I don't know. He went home and he like really took it to the next level. He's been doing activism left and right. That's getting so much media coverage.
A lot too.
Like he's like a nonstop activist, and he lives in Texas.
I've been pushing the Free State card on him hard. He would be.
I don't think he'll move.
I think he's got a big base in Texas.
And plus, Texas needs liberty too. You know.
Yeah,
that's true.
Nice
of you to look out for the Texans.
He actually did a open carry event where he fed the homeless like a month ago, which is really cool. But just recently, he's to get him and his group is the people responsible for the mock
mass shooting down in Texas.
Oh yeah, I watched that. Yeah, oh, you news coverage of that.
Yeah, that's him. He organized that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Was he the one that they interviewed on RT?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So yeah, that's Myrna.
Okay. RT. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, so again, that's don'tcomply.com. And he went home and he was just doing all this great activism. And I look at us and I'm like, we try to do activism, but you know, we hate going courtrooms and we don't really want to get arrested and all of that good stuff. But I know you've worked with people who are kind of on the, I don't even know the word, anti or pro gun.
Yeah, you've been around a lot of people that have been arrested.
Oh yeah, back in the days when I lived in Keene.
Are you like, what is your like constant gun stance at this point? Like, I feel like that's just like the mainstream media topic.
Oh, like, what is my stance on guns?
Yeah, I mean, you were co-host to someone who.
Yeah, I'm pro gun.
Wait, what? I always get confused about what Adam Kokesh did.
That was like almost a year after she left. She wasn't a part of that. Kokesh got arrested for open carrying in D.C.
Oh, okay.
His house was raided by.
I totally missed that. Luckily.
Yeah, good for you. I know. Y'all. Good for you. You got off the boat when it was the right time.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. You made the right call.
I don't really know that whole story. That's like way before my time, and I researched
it. I honestly don't either. I really don't know the whole story on it. I just know it happened after I left. And
His protest, I mean, it's what I'm hearing from just, you know, the outside looking in, to open carry anywhere, I feel like should be his right. So I'm sad he got raided, but
he's still facing jail issues.
Yeah, I feel like that something like that should have been done. So I don't really see what the bad part is or why.
Well, I remember following that when it was coming up, where he was trying to organize an entire open carry march on the Capitol, which was really ballsy at the time. I knew it wasn't going to happen. Not that many people would show up, and they'd be sitting targets if they actually did happen.
Besides, thinking about, okay, so how is that going to look politically, and how are people? What kind of message does it send? But doing like, that, besides, besides maybe people who could be like, no, it's not like a violent thing. The rhetoric behind the, what was it called? The Next American Revolution or something?
Okay, yeah, well, we're going to have to talk more about that when we come back.
Adam Kokesh is no American such thing.
Yeah. Okay. But it's so weird. I find it interesting going over like libertarian history. It's kind of interesting.
Yeah. There's so much that I feel like I'm ignorant about that I feel like bad. Like I don't want to comment on something if I'm wrong, especially if it's something where it could imply that I would know because I have some kind of insider hookup. I wouldn't want to say something if it's wrong. Especially to like try to watch, like to make sure I'm not. So choose
every. No, I just don't know what's going on. Like I don't really get it. I don't know.
Rob try to. You're
speaking to. I'm.
You're gonna summarize the story.
I didn't know we were gonna go into the whole Kokesh raid. That wasn't in the show notes.
Good. I don't know what the big deal is, so I didn't know not to ask that question.
That's not a bad question to ask. The reason
is because of this Next American Revolution stuff being so crazy and weird and like not something that I want to be associated with.
What is it?
It's like,
what is it about?
Well, I don't know, but we'd have to find like one of the things for it.
Wait, is our commercial? Hold on. On the
Rebel Love Show. And it's
the first time I've heard it.
Rebel Mistress. We're the sexiest podcast coming straight out of Manchester, New Hampshire.
Not as sexy as you, my Rebel Mistress.
Oh.
Oh, maybe not.
Topics include sex,
drugs,
anarchy,
and the police.
We are your premiere.
polyamory, hippie stoner, and all-around fun podcast.
We broadcast every Tuesday night at 10 p.m. Eastern on LRN.fm and rebellofshow.com.
Want some extra fun? Check out and subscribe to our YouTube
channel. I'm looking for the next American.
Subscribe to us on iTunes and Stitcher. And join the Rebel Love crew by liking our Facebook page at The Rebel Love Show.
We're just trying to spread the love
of a liberated world.
Peace.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals.
The final, was it early final?
Tuesday, the final American Revolution.
Well, just back to the gun stuff. I just feel like these kind of protests are valid. And I feel like people should be doing this, even if they are scared of like jail time. Not necessarily me, but.
Well, when we come back from the break, I do want to go over what the actual mock, what a mock mass shooting looks like and what it was.
Yeah.
Because that's, I've never seen anyone ever do anything like that before.
I've never seen that. Was there a video?
Yeah.
Getting in their
car. I just saw the coverage of it. And hearing the
Liberty Radio Network. Yeah, there's video of it. It's pretty good. In reality with your own micro
radio station. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how you can put our programs on the air in your area. You can have lrn.fm running around the clock, and you can even add in your own local shows. Building a radio station is simple, but programming isn't. That's where lrn.fm comes in. Learn more at broadcast.lrn.fm. That's broadcast.lrn.fm.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary.
Oh,
if
shit.
Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs,
I wouldn't shop there.
So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We are broadcasting live on LRN.fm and IPM Nation. And go check us out at rebellofshow.com/live. We do interact with the chat. We got Allie Havens here in the studio. So
she's interacting with the chat as well.
Yeah, she's in the chat right now too. So feel free to get in there, ask some questions. And we are interacting with you. So
are we going to do a Q&A or something?
Sure, if they want. I don't care. If
we could ask Allie Havens 10 questions, what would it be? What's your favorite color?
Or
this question number one. Do you like long walks on the beach?
Of course. But not too long, because like sometimes you'll be like, oh, it's great. And then you're like, well, I have to walk all the way back. So that kind of sucks.
There you have it, people. Allie Haven's your dream woman.
There you go.
What about mock shootings? Do you like mock shootings?
Yeah, do you like mock mass shootings?
I've never witnessed this. It sounds really controversial, which gets my blood pumping, which I like. I really like the idea that like people are going to be outraged.
Can I just say that people didn't really have any...
And it's peaceful, clearly.
Can I just say, people didn't really have any good comebacks. Like, I read one that I think I posted in there, and the only comeback they had was that it was, like, distasteful. But, like, not that anything he said, like, wasn't accurate or just, like, trying to disprove his theory. They're just like, we don't like it. It's not pretty. And I'm like, that's all you got.
Well, so anyways...
Was it on a college campus?
It was at University of Texas, I believe. UT Texas.
There's supposed to be places where people do stuff like this. They're supposed to be ideally there'd be all kinds of hijinks like this.
No, I think
all around
maybe
the school,
like
people
the
trying to make
one.
A point and people being like, whoa, man, it really made me think.
Well,
that's what you want.
Well, apparently, there was a new law that's signed and that's going to affect soon that allows people to conceal carry on campuses in Texas.
Which not is, in their classroom, not in
the
dorm.
Well, there's the campuses can apparently block off, create gun-free zones, but the entire campus can't be. So only like part of it can be. I don't know.
So there's only like one like place. That.
Yeah. Anyways.
Can you describe a mock? What,
yeah.
What
mock so is? Basically, they did this thing where they announced that they're doing a mock mass shooting. And basically, they have a bunch of cardboard guns that they created. They took the gun-free zone t-shirts that the other protesters had and wore that, and with a bullhorn did a talk about her, the nearest good guy with the guns like 9 minutes away, meanwhile boom, this person's dead.
They can kill you every 30 seconds. Yeah, every 30 seconds like one person dies, two people dead.
And the counter protesters, mind you, the counter protesters were going, their solution to the mock mass shooting was to have a bunch of dildos and make fart sounds. I'm not making that shit up either. That's actually legit. Like, yeah, that's what they did.
And so he made a meme out of it. He's like, I wish I could pull it up right now. I probably could. He's like, your dildo $2.
That kind of seems fart machine, more insensitive $13. To me. I mean, if the protest is about, you know, putting an end to these unnecessary deaths because of the gun-free zones, then to react that way, you would think if they're saying it's distasteful, then maybe.
This dildo thing is actually a recurring thing. It's like,
yeah, that's like a new way that like the they're left like to protesting protest guns is dildos. It's
like open carrying dildos.
Are you sure it wasn't just a pro dildo?
No.
Rally?
No, it was not a pro.
Yeah, we talked
rally.
About it actually that, on that, Flaming fine Freedom.
It was a pro dildo rally.
I think
it's just
everyone's
like conflicting schedules. Like they just dildo.
They didn't have that many protests or gatherings for different things every day.
They had the FSB organizers do it or something, and they just like, oh, well, same time.
So anyways, big props to Murdoch. He got like world attention on it. Like I just Google search mass mock shooting in Texas, and it's just article after article. I mean, it got covered by like Times Magazine, New York Times, CNN, Fox News, MSNBC, RT, like every
time.
I
think the greatest thing on there, hands down, babe, can you pull up this picture and maybe show Alec, is the one thing that every mass shooting has is this like one white chick holding a phone just screaming.
Yeah, because like, she's a crisis
just
actor.
Just this one girl. The crisis actor is just always just like in front of the camera on the phone screaming. Like they had the girl come, the same one, I think, come and pose for like his mock shooting. And like that's like the picture that they use for like the cover of everything.
Well, she's just cropped in it, but
it's great.
Yeah. So I mean, well, that's a conspiracy where all these people, where whenever there's a shooting, there's this woman that is screaming. Like it looks like she's screaming.
You know the woman.
Like whenever there's an actual shooting.
Is the one woman in the news that they always show?
This sounds familiar.
Yeah, it was like actually a big conspiracy with like the Sandy Hook shootings. They're like, oh, they hired the same girl to go like cry at everything.
Same crisis actress, yeah.
Because it was like, well, this shit is crazy, you guys, but it's not. It doesn't really look like it based on the picture. So we need someone to be freaking out,
even more.
Freaking out that
so we'll have this girl.
The person can relate to and be like, oh my gosh, if I was her, that would be awful.
That's stupid.
Like, so if you go to Facebook.com and go add Murdoch Biscotti and literally scroll through like five pages of posts from like literally the last day, because that's how much he posts. You'll see this great photo that he edited where it's the gun-free zone with the crisis actor right in front of it.
So let me ask all you guys. Oh, yeah, exactly. Let me ask all you guys, like, I think we all agree that we're pro-gun, but if we're all pro-gun, like, your reasons are, you know, do you personally want a gun, or you just feel like everyone should have a gun and no one should take that and want one? Like,
I don't think everyone should.
I guess I didn't. I wasn't sure about the question. Maybe I jumped the gun on answering the question.
Yeah, let's go a little deeper into it.
I'm pro-gun for myself as far as like whether or not I want to like have guns myself or have them in my life, have people around me with guns, in the sense that I'm comfortable with people owning guns around me.
Yeah.
And
but do you like go to the shooting range yourself? Because like
I have
you can depend on other people to stop that active shooter, but
I actually don't open or conceal carry because of that, because I don't feel like, I feel like that's a responsibility that I'd want to take on seriously. Like I'd want to feel like I knew how to use the thing.
Yeah, you gotta be prepared.
Yeah, definitely. But there's so many
around
guns.
It. I still have a little bit because I didn't really grow up. I didn't grow up like going to the shooting range with my dad or anything like that. Like,
yeah,
I don't.
I mean, I grew up in a place where everyone had guns, but it wasn't a big deal, so no one talked about it. But no one was teaching us how to use guns, mm-hmm. and it wasn't until I came here that I didn't really understand. And you know, the media manipulates it, and it makes it seem like it's this massively scary thing. And I actually went shooting for the first time with Rob, and he'd been shooting before. And
but
Pedro
not that
said,
much.
"Not that much." But the guy who taught us how to shoot, named Pedro. He goes, listen, first lesson about this gun, you see this trigger. The gun's not going to go off unless you pull it. So, like, he just wanted me to know that, drill that first thing into my head. He was like, it doesn't matter what you heard, what you've thought, like, what you've seen. The only way this gun is going to go off is if you pull the trigger. And so that kind of shifted control, like, unto me. And I feel like that's what's important because you want to feel like you're in control the moment like that you have a gun. And I am pro-gun and I'd like to own a gun because I feel like guns do keep us safe. And as long as we're properly trained, like I like to have a gun. I like to practice shooting and I'd have no problem taking a course. But, you know, that's something that I want to do on my own because I want to own a gun. So I feel like, no, everyone maybe shouldn't have a gun, but who am I to decide, you know? Like, no one's forcing me to want to take these courses or do that.
Exactly.
Like, I could just go buy a gun on the black market and put it in my pocket today. Like, but I don't because I would like to know more, you know? And it's just, like, the rational decision I made.
I just think it's a smart, intelligent decision for a lot of people. And I like how guns are such an equalizer that if there's not like a, well, I'm physically stronger than you, so I can dominate you effect.
Yeah.
When you don't know who could have a gun because there's not that.
Anyone
I like
can fight
that.
Back with
I prefer
gun.
It that way as a small female.
Well, yeah, that's definitely.
There's not.
Yeah, most women should have a gun on them if they feel, if they need to protect
themselves. I should have something like a gun, a mace.
There is something to be said for considering other, I mean, I kind of find the conversations about, you know, the problems with guns being it's like a lethal option.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if maybe I don't carry because I'm not really comfortable with that. So.
Well, when we come back, we'll talk about guns.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you up to $50,000.
So what's going on in the chat?
Your funds can be available in 5 days. No application fees, no annual fees. Quick
ban
access
web keys.
To up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
I'm bringing it back till everyone goes.
Who is Ella Run Cuck?
Yeah,
right.
800-430-4505. That's 800-430-4505.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found.
Does my magic mud actually work?
It would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time.
Do people
my
actually
magic
buy
mud
that?
Is black tooth powder. Mm-hmm. The difference it made
my
in my
magic
teeth,
mud.
One
is that like a legit
was
thing?
Yeah.
With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please
hello,
go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25.
Yeah, I've seen
hey, Wookiees is what's his name, right?
Yeah, it's what's his name.
I shouldn't say what's his name.
Well, maybe he doesn't want
I just know him as
Wookiees.
I just know him as Wookiees. I don't care what his real name is. I'll just always know him as Wookiees. Just like I go by what people go by online.
Yeah, but this particular person has a Facebook.
The troll from the UK.
Program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented groups. Support all your favorite organizations, but make sure you get $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm.
Is
Free Press Publications is publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press, movement.
It's hot.
There's no ventilation. Rob nailed the curtain to the window.
You can open the door for a little bit.
Also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom oriented.
Or we can hotbox the room.
Well, actually, no, it won't. Yeah, just open it first. Sorry.
Yeah, let's hotbox the room. Yeah, let's hotbox.
Well, leave it open. Leave it open.
Are you going topless on the show? Yes. This is a good show.
And the monthly newspaper, FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening app for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm.
When was the last time you guys had a guest on the show?
It's been a couple episodes.
And share the link on social media and let your friends.
We had Tila on last month. Yeah. Before that, we had Carlos.
We had Mateus on recently.
Oh, yeah, Mateus is on right before that.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the
Silk Road Underground. Is this a long break?
No. We're coming back in a few seconds. I still don't have a show clock. I plan to get one at some point. It's a running.
He's saying it's really a show clock. You have it.
I pretty much already memorized it at this point. I've gotten to the point
I know when it comes on.
You don't know when it comes on. That's bullshit.
I know. Various methods, including
Bitcoin. Visit freeross.org. That is not the case at all.
It's absolutely the case.
You're listening to the best. All right, so am I bringing back UPN Rec? What were we doing?
I'm bringing it back.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Do I have cool graphics behind me?
Yeah.
It's happening. Gotta watch this.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. I am your Rebel Mistress, and we're talking about the pro-gun part of the Rebel Love Show. And, you know, as we're pro-gun, none of us in this room has a gun. So I feel like we're all fucking hypocrites, man. Just kidding, guys. I support your choice to not. Or why don't you have a gun, Rob? Is it just because you're lazy or?
Yeah. No, it's not lazy. It's just sometimes there's other stuff I want to buy.
Yeah, like tattoos and stuff.
Yeah, or but like adventures.
I get really.
Or, I don't know, maybe an engagement ring for my rebel mistress here. I don't know.
Let me get like post apocalyptic here. I just feel like if the zombie apocalypse happened tomorrow, we'd all be screwed.
And you better start your learning how to use your ring as a weapon.
Yeah.
Look, I didn't ask for this rock, okay? I said I'd be happy without the diamonds.
You wanted it.
I just wanted a stone in the middle and he got out. But anyway, no, I think I'd be ready. Like, I want to take Krav Maga. I feel like defending yourself is so important. The only thing is, Allie, I just need a partner to help with these Krav Maga classes is the only thing. We need to, like, take all these self-defense classes together. We won't be alone.
I like the idea of taking a self-defense class.
We should do that.
See? That sounds nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys should take one.
I mean, you should too, Rob. What would you do?
I don't know.
I'm gonna get a gun.
I don't know. For some reason, I have this funny. I have this funny image of self defense class.
As like
is it
what?
For women? Like self defense for women?
No, I want to learn how to fight like a man. I don't want to just fight like a man, fight like a woman.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think
maybe.
Like women's self defense is mostly like crotch grabs and kicks.
Yeah.
And
no, I want to like learn how to like kill someone in one punch or something.
That'd be nice. If I could do that.
Like if I had to.
Yeah.
Secret weapon. Don't even have to try very hard. Probably just break a knuckle or two. But anyway, I just feel like self-defense is so important. I feel like we slack on that so much. Not that I really think the end of the world is near, kind of. But I just feel like we won't be ready.
Does everyone kind of think that if it was them, I mean, clearly if someone had a weapon, it would had a gun or something, it would be different, or a knife, I guess. They cut me or something, it would be different. But just like if someone tried to grab me, I like to think that like I could get away easily.
But could you? Like, if I walked up in the room and I spooked you, what would be your first reaction?
If you spooked me?
Yeah, if I just, like, ran in here and I spooked you, would your first...
I'd be very tense and, like, I'd probably, like, immediately turn around just to...
See, that's good. I ran up to Renee
I scared her
and she just, like, kept looking.
Easily scared.
But, like, she just kept looking forward. I'm like, if someone's coming to kill you and they, like, are trying to kill you, like, what are you going to do? Just pretend like you're invisible? Well, she was like, yes, I'll just sit there and like stay and hope that they go away.
If I wasn't expecting something and someone like, you know, poke you or something from the side or something like that, I would immediately like elbow or like do something like that's I hit someone one time when, at work, like when they like try to scare me, like I elbowed them really hard in the gut. I kind of felt bad afterward. I'm like, I didn't know who it was. Like who the hell was grabbing me?
Isn't it always kind of, I think it's cute and endearing, but it always at first when your significant other like maybe comes up from behind you and like puts their arm around you or touches you in some romantic way. But like if it wasn't them, it would be like totally be like, dude, what the fuck? But because it turns out to be them. So, oh, it's fine. But I'm just saying that moment where you're not sure what's going on, where you're like second guessing it for a second.
Has there been moments where you second guess me?
No. Only when you try to, like, you try to scare me, but you're not very good at it.
I haven't done that in a while, and I was really good at
it. I hate being, okay, so when I was a child, just going off on a tangent here, I was with these people, and they hid under the bed, like, in a dark room after I got out, like, the bathtub. I'm, like, 5, and they hid in the room, and I was going in the bed. It was completely dark, and they just start reaching, like, underneath the bed and, like, trying to grab me, and I was, like, scared as shit because it was just, like, so unexpected.
That sounds terrifying.
It was, like, multiple hands. I would be terrified. And I was, like, a little kid, and ever since then, like, when someone tries to, like, jump out and scare me, I literally have a panic attack. But you're lucky I don't have a knife or a gun. I'd probably just stab you. So
I used to love scaring you for a while. I did that for, oh, my God.
I got
like
pissed.
Once, it was, like, once a week.
Anyway,
I left that out for a while.
You had to put an end to that.
I overdid it.
Yeah, you did. I feel like these mock shootings are just teaching us, like, or reminding us that we need to be prepared because we don't know what could happen. And your first priority should be self-defense. And I feel like we need to be reminded of that no matter how unpleasant or how many people have to apparently go to jail because of it. Like, we need to be reminded that it's our right to carry guns. And
what about for, like, heroin dealers? Are they allowed to carry guns?
Yes.
Too? Really? Heroin dealers?
They're allowed.
What about prostitutes? Are you allowed we're going to allow prostitutes to
especially
open carry.
Prostitutes.
Especially give prostitutes.
Most prostitutes are open carrying. Just assume that if you're going to abduct a prostitute in 2015.
Okay, what about coyotes? Can we allow coyotes to cross the border with immigrants from Syria open carrying?
What the fuck is a coyote?
Those are people who help
you cross borders and stuff, like, legally.
Oh, that's nice.
Get away with
good
it.
Good for them.
Well, they're like travel agents
The idea is like, there's a reason people pay them to do it, because they're providing a service.
But, yeah, they're providing a service.
But it's kind of like...
Yeah, it was in weeds.
It's kind of like in the same sense...
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
It's kind of in the same sense that pimps provide a service.
Yeah, they're providing a service to prostitutes.
Yes, and so in that...
Let the market speak.
But the problem is that a lot of people, like a lot of coyotes, might not be good people. They might be like,
that's
really
why
the
people
them.
Who are like, are like, they're taking need to have guns, like in Weeds. Like the guy was like being a fucking asshole.
Like in Weeds.
And he shot him in the leg. He was like, I'm sorry, man. I had to shoot you in the leg, but you were being a dick.
Well, yeah, do you remember how they were going to be the nice coyotes?
Yeah. They were.
Yeah, they didn't make any goddamn money on
it. Yeah, they were bringing people and weren't even getting paid for it.
No. So you're in favor of coyotes bringing people over?
Okay, let me.
Did I say coyotes?
Coyotes.
Let me just clarify. I am in favor of any person who wants to own a gun, and I know I'm saying this realizing that people can be insane. But let me tell you, people thought Ted Bundy was just your friendly guy next door, and I bet he would have been able to get a gun if he really wanted to. The Craigslist killer, the guy had the fucking friendliest face I had ever seen.
That's the most hilarious part when you break down the whole, like, let's ban guns thing. As much as you might not like guns as a weapon, as a personal choice for yourself to protect yourself, you might prefer something like pepper spray or like a home security system or a guy who stands at your apartment door or whatever, or the, you know, high rise door.
Yeah, if you want to
get a guard or something, that might be better for you.
Yeah. So you don't have to deal with
the
responsibility.
But outlawing guns is going to keep criminals from having them. It's just that there's no way to.
Well, if that's the case, you must be in favor of all those criminals having guns.
Yes.
No, I'm just realistic about what their motivations are.
It's their right to own a gun. That's like the bottom line. It doesn't matter. Like, you can start breaking it down on individual spectrums all you want. And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter because it's your right to have a gun.
Yeah,
and it's everyone's right to have a gun. And one way to protect yourself, if you don't want someone having a gun, is for you to get one. Like, if you feel like you feel scared and unprotected because someone that you think is dangerous have a gun, then you need to find a way to protect yourself.
No, it's true. Absolutely. It doesn't make sense to say that certain groups in society can have the really deadly weapons, but then like other groups can't. That just clearly creates a power dynamic.
But that's the thing. They're not saying they can't have guns. They're not saying all of us will get rid of our guns. We're going to go to a town center and everyone, the police and all, are going to throw in their guns. No, they're just saying you throw away your guns. Like, and they get to keep theirs. And that's the problem. Therein lies the problem. Once we move on, you've given all your guns away. And guess who has guns now? Well, nothing but the government and the police officers.
I love how people who talk about gun control, they're just talking about a certain group of people having control over another group of people with fucking guns. Like, how else are you going to get rid of guns? By using guns on other people. They're advocating gun use, but that's okay because it's achieving their goals by disarming more people. So, like, they think that makes
them... It's totally true. There's no way to get around that.
Yeah. When you start disarming, like, your citizens, that's, like, one way you're going to, like, gain a dictatorship. And like, when no one has guns, your government.
This is one thing that, like, you know, I really want to ask, I will ask people a lot of times when they're in favor of gun regulations or banning guns and stuff like that. Okay, what if I have a gun on me? Are you going to take it from me? Are you going to ban me from having a gun? Are you going to have other people come to my home to take my guns?
Well, they'd probably, if I was going to play devil's advocate, would be like, well, it's not, I guess some people might say all guns or any gun, but I think a lot of people are going to be like, oh no, just like certain guns, Rob. I mean, you don't want to have the kind of guns that I would ban. You wouldn't even have any reason you'd need that. I don't have a problem with you having a gun. It's just certain guns.
Like
are unnecessary. Like, I guess it's really hard to play, but
like what?
Yeah.
That's not true. Like I said, you
like
should always
it's unnecessary is not an argument that people can't have it. Like lots of things that clearly shouldn't be against the law aren't necessary.
You should always like advocate. Like I'm saying, sitting here saying these mock protests like remind us that we should always be prepared because we don't know what to expect. And that's my argument. I can have a fucking bazooka, a AK-47. I can have whatever the goddamn gun I want. If I need to protect myself from who or whatever, I'm going to be equipped. More when we come back.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people
to the ideas of
liberty. Yo, it's MVG.
He's in the audience. We don't have a casting couch for you. I'm sorry. You can come chill.
Said a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live.
And if you can close the door, well, you can come in, chill.
Hey.
Years ago,
yeah, that was what I was trying to get up for a second. I thought I could get around and close, and I couldn't. If the door's open, it affects that camera shot. I can't use that shot. You can have a cigarette, yeah. But if you want to go outside for a second, we're not back until 11:06.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the amp only Facebook group and amp podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com. If you can't listen to the Liberty Radio Network's internet streams, free satellite channel, or radio affiliates, no worries. You can listen to LRN.FM from any phone, anywhere. Add this number to your phone. 213-493-0309. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Liberty Radio Network listen lines are locked into our stream 24 hours a day. Call 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
More Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Kane in the Shire, the Liberty Radio Company of the World, this is Derek W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, December 15th, 2015. Silver is trading at $13.71 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,064 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $452. Antiwar.com reports, in what appears to be the single deadliest strike of the nine-month Saudi war in Yemen, forces loyal to the Shiite Houthis fired an OTR-21 Tajka tactical ballistic missile at a pro-Saudi coalition base near Taiz, with early reports putting the death toll around 152 troops. The identities of all the slain are still being sorted out, but dozens of foreign troops are among the slain, including Saudi Special Forces Commander Colonel Abdullah Sayyan. Emirati and Moroccan soldiers were also identified among the slain. The Houthis reported the attack was carried out by one of the nation's few remaining Tachka missiles and reported causing many losses in lives and military equipment, claiming to have destroyed Apache helicopters in the strike. This is the second Tachka missile used in the war, with a previous strike against the Emirati base in Marib province back in September, an attack which killed 45 soldiers. These stand as the two deadliest strikes against combatants during the war, though there have been several incidents where scores of civilians were slain. Yemen was believed to have around 10 Tachka missiles at the start of the war. It is unclear how many remain, as many early attacks targeted bases believed to hold Yemen's missile arsenal.
Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co.
UPI reports civilians operating most types of recreational drones must register the devices by February 19th under new rules announced by the Federal Aviation Administration on Monday. Owners of small unmanned aircraft weighing between 0.55 and 55 pounds
make America
and suitable
gay again.
For onboard cameras and other recreational uses, according to the FAA, must register with the FAA starting December 21st, either through a paper process or online. The FAA is waiving a $5 registration fee for the first 30 days from December 21st to January 20th to encourage quick registration. Anthony Fox, the Secretary of Transportation, said in a statement, "Make no mistake, unmanned aircraft enthusiasts are aviators, and with that title comes a great deal of responsibility. The registration process involves providing the FAA with the drone owner's name, home address, and an email address. Registrants must be over 13 years old, and the FAA will provide an identification number to be displayed on the aircraft."
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at
RRBI. Okay, made it. And then I thought I used too much crap. But then I was like, there's not really
Reuters
such thing as too much crap.
Judge on Monday ruled that Chicago police used excessive force on a man who died after he was dragged by handcuffs out of his cell and down a hallway 3 years ago. The ruling came as Chicago police and Mayor Rahm Emanuel face intense scrutiny over the police department's use of force. Protesters have called for Emanuel's resignation since last month's release of a video showing a police officer shooting a teenager to death. In the separate case of the man dragged by handcuffs, Officer Keith Kirkland and Supervising Officer Sergeant Tommy Walker are liable in their treatment of Philip Coleman, who later died at the hospital, according to court documents. Coleman was arrested for domestic battery on December 12, 2012. After he refused to go to court the next morning, several
someone heard
Make
America Gay Again
tasered. Court records showed that Kirkland handcuffed, shackled, and dragged the motionless Coleman by the handcuffs. The tasering and dragging were caught on video cameras, but there is no accompanying audio, according to court documents. The Coleman video was released to the public last week. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
NASA announced the discovery of a mile-wide asteroid this week that could potentially trigger a global level of extinction, forcing upscale fashion retailer Nordstrom out of business. Researchers confirm that the celestial object is traveling at speeds exceeding 29,000 miles per hour, threatening to slam into the planet with more than a million megatons of force, enough to jeopardize operations at all 117 full-line Nordstrom locations.
Hey, babe. Unless we can find some way to divert or intercept the asteroid, all 7 billion people
we're going live
in
like 30 seconds.
62,500 Nordstrom employees may die. Even if the asteroid breaks into smaller pieces upon entering to the atmosphere, a death toll as low as several hundred million could still slow foot traffic in stores and reduce online orders from Nordstrom subsidiary Hot Look.
Humanity is surprised it still hasn't figured out an alternative to letting power-hungry decide everything, and a magical office worker is able to turn everything he touches into more work for his colleagues.
This is the Onion News Network.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And we came back from the break, finally, almost didn't make it in here, but we did at the last seconds. And I don't care if it's Liberty or not, but I grew up as a, I grew up on Star Wars, and I got two people sitting at this table right now that just watched Star Wars, like, yes, for the first time.
With virgin
in
eyes.
Different orders.
In different orders, yeah, which makes it even more intense because I have my Rebel Mistress here. She watched it in the machete order that MVG made me convinced me to do. So, which is, I talked about it a little bit in the last order, but basically,
really?
You start with the classics.
Yeah, you start with the classics.
Mateus convinced you to do the machete order?
I was sold by reading it.
So I found out about the machete order because someone on Facebook was like, my kids are, I want to introduce them to Star Wars. And, I kind of, I'm thinking I'm just going to go in chronological order, but I'm not really sure. Does anyone have any advice about how I should introduce them? And so many people said machete order. So I looked it up. And as someone who knows nothing about Star Wars going into it, I naturally assumed that I didn't realize that they were released out of order. Like, I thought the episode one would be like the oldest Star Wars movie and, you know, consecutively.
I
was confused by the conversation about it, and it was also very spoily, so I was like, I don't want to look too much into this. And I saw something about Jar Jar Binks and like how everyone hates this character. And
well, yeah, because he's the new Sith Lord.
What?
They all knew ahead of time going
like
in.
How is Jar Jar Binks, like, I just don't get, like, the whole, okay, for, let's just rewind. So the first episode you watched was which one?
Episode one.
Okay, and the first episode I watched was episode four?
Episode four, A New Hope.
A New Hope. So I watched it. Sorry, I don't know. I remember which ones I watched, but
I don't blame
I'm confused
you because you
watched
them.
I know. Heaven forbid. I imagine you remember
to keep
the
up
movies
with
that you watched.
Yes,
I know,
but like all those fucking, that order is ridiculous. I knew they were released in a different order though, because I watched that 70s show. But
did you find that? Did you find the storyline to be easy to follow in the order that you did it?
What was the first episode you watched? One?
One.
So you watched
one,
it
two,
in
three,
order.
Four, five, six.
Okay, so I liked four. I liked A New Hope. And it's a total, it's a different storyline. It's their kids. So it's kind of, it doesn't matter if you watch the other ones before that.
I fell asleep during four, like a couple times.
What?
I had trouble getting through it. I was like,
okay, it does.
And part of it is like,
slow, but it's
these graphics are so shitty.
No, but
I
like that. I like rah-rah for like those graphics because I'm like, oh, that's so cute. Like, it's so
old. No, it's cute. I agree.
Like,
it's endearing and everything.
Liked it.
But I'm confused. I'm like, I don't know what's going on. I feel like I'm supposed to. Who are they fighting right now? Like, it's
really.
I find it.
I'm four.
I think I might be talking about five.
I don't know.
Both
I
of just, them, really. I was like,
I felt
bit.
Like I get
the Empire.
Yeah,
I and then when they break, because I
fighting with
because I
rebels.
Watched the you know I watched the new ones first, and so the fighting in that one, the
see, I was on. Can I just?
Why can't I think of what it's called? Not laser beam, but what is it called?
Lightsaber.
Thank you. The lightsaber fighting and shit, and the one, two, and three is one thing, and then you go to like four and you're like, oh my
so
god,
wait, can I say
there's this intense battle, and
I feel like I don't want to spoil it for people because I just saw it the first time. So there might be people who haven't haven't.
But anyway,
okay. I'm just saying there's an intense battle.
Show, like, odds are, who cares?
Wait,
like, and it was like very underwhelming to be used to one type of saber fighting.
I don't know. Maybe I just am not like as critical fighting as you guys, but I didn't get that. But for me, four. I was trying to say for so long, I forgot. I like four because I was unbiased. Like, that's the one reason I wouldn't have liked watching like them in that order, because when I did get to one, I really liked Anakin. Like, I really liked Anakin, and I had nothing but hope for Darth Vader because I had just watched that scene. I found out that was his father. I'm like a knuckle heart, like, for father son, like, reuniting. I'm like, oh my god, this is good. Like, maybe he loves his child. And okay, then I go back to one, and then Obi-Wan. I see Anakin's this nice guy.
So you
and
see,
that makes me really root for Darth Vader.
I'm trying to figure out the order. You saw four and then one?
Yeah. No.
No, the way I had her watch it, so I started with A New Hope, which is episode 4, and then went to episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back. Darth Vader chops off Luke's arms. Like, Luke, yeah. I am your father. Blah, blah, blah. Okay.
So you're all like, Darth Vader is this, like, scary, ominous guy.
Yeah, and then I just found out, like, he's Luke's father. And I like Luke, and I want him to have a father because he just lost everything.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
so,
he lost his entire family.
Yeah, and then what was the one
because
I watched
Darth
after
Vader
him?
Killed them, by the way.
Yeah,
he had his family killed.
Yeah, so, I mean, I get that.
Stormtroopers work for Darth Vader.
I get that, but again, he was like this dark, ominous person, and it's like I didn't.
Well, you know what?
Only thing I know is that it's his father, and I don't have any bias towards him at that point. I didn't know he murdered like a bunch of kids and all this other stuff that made him evil.
And you know what? No one ever questioned the lightsaber in that situation.
That's totally not. Like, my experience watching it in chronological order was that it was like, oh my gosh, this cute ass kid. What a cute little kid. And he's like the hero of this movie.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I love this kid. And then it's like the next movie, it's like, you know, Anakin is this kind of like every guy in my junior high school class, like kind of creepy, like hyper.
He had teenage angst.
Yeah, he's angsty and like. Mateus and I watched it together, and I was like, I don't really like, I think I'm supposed to like Anakin, but I don't really like the guy. Just funny. No. He turns out to be Darth Vader.
It's like, and
oh, that's right. You didn't know.
I was
you
like,
didn't know
I don't know. I just
get
the creepy, but I liked him better when he was a little kid. And Mateus is like, yeah, that's what everyone says.
No,
which
no.
is hilarious.
I understood his teenage angst. Like, I definitely understood his teenage angst, and I felt like he was just confused, and I felt bad for him because he was really in love, and I'm a sucker for a love story.
Oh yeah.
And I saw him as Darth Vader to begin with, so to see all that goodness in him from being a kid to being like this angsty teenager and then somehow transforming into this evil human adult, like it was like hard going from like that all that concentrated evil to this just like this little kid who became an antsy teenager. Like, It's not, you were a teenager. I bet your mom found you annoying as shit. Like, all of us.
I have a question.
That's
for
not
you.
Anything abnormal. But then it was like that whole seduction of the dark side. It was really sad for me.
Well,
at
don't
that
forget
point.
That Anakin was like a slave. And
yeah,
his mother was a slave.
Exactly, which is why I had so much compassion. And even when he was seduced by the dark side, it was just more of, you know, I feel sad for him, not I hate him. So it kind of went that way throughout and out, and then it was a happy ending. So, and then I really liked that. So I just felt like I really liked the order I watched it in, because if I would have watched it like him, like from this kid to the adult and then somehow magically becoming Darth Vader, I wouldn't have liked seeing that. I liked seeing like Darth Vader, this evil concentrated person, and you're trying to figure him out. And then you go back and then you see like he was this good person.
It definitely didn't feel to me like, oh my gosh, how did Darth Vader ever become this crazy guy? It was like very much like you're in there with Anakin. You really want Anakin to do well. You're all concerned, you know, when he like slaughters that village that had his, that was like mistreating his
animals.
They
had it coming. They had it coming.
It's like, you know, you feel like compassion and stuff for him, and you're kind of almost like, well, they kind of deserve it or something. Like the dark side starts to take you over and you're like, oh,
but is it the dark side? Yeah, I feel like it's again. Okay, well, I feel like it's morality. I feel like it was his seduction of the dark side was all morality. I definitely felt like it was his choice.
I definitely think the killing of the whole village was like, that was like fed into what eventually made him Darth Vader. and that was used against him as part of like the argument. It's like, dude, you clearly have like hate and anger in you, which we can all recognize and like and feel compassion for, because it's like, well, dude's been
He was also very restricted by the Jedi. The scene where he's like flying the apple into Padme's mouth and he's like, if my Jedi masters caught me doing this, they'd have a nervous breakdown. Like, he was always felt like he was like restricted.
Yeah, because Jedi are religious zealots, and they take these young boys and they don't allow them to have sex with anyone and tell them and teach them this very hardcore version of the Force. And that's what
I have
they
a
do.
Comment. I think you're wrong.
Well, more when we come back.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online
poker site? He wants to fucking fly an apple into her mouth. Then so what? Like, they shouldn't be, like, saying no to that. That's probably what made him evil, more so than killing same people. All that restriction.
I don't think, can we not talk? I want to bring this back. I don't want to talk about Star Wars during the break, because I'm going to blow my load. I don't really want to re-say it, because it's not going to have the same thing, right? And start playing
now. Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save
applied
25% on all purchases at Amazon.
To the green
screen. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought
I
much
about it.
I think
it actually has helped a lot. That you can get there's a lot. Amazon, there's a little. There's less white.
Get a 25% discount on nearly everything.
That light's in the way, so I really don't have much.
I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it.
You're cool. I miss our casting couch. What if we have like an account?
Do this right now. Don't wait.
Can you be?
Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things.
Yeah,
SaveItFirst.com right now. Get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you.
I want to try
15% to 25% off of everything at Amazon. SaveItFirst.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet
supplies. Well, that would just be spiding me because I don't want
the whole thing. Grocery, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.lrn.fm. Get all your shopping done. Get a great deal. And a portion of your purchase goes to benefit the Liberty Radio Network. When you shop at Amazon,
you need to bring that up at some point. You're bringing it back. We're going back to Star Wars.
But first, before we jump in back to our hardcore Star Wars argument, I'm going to promote my book because I'm a promotion whore.
The last application you filled out, when it was time to hit submit, did your nerve spike? You didn't get the approval you seek. There's a better way. We teach you exactly what
he said he can't look at my book because he's a Mormon.
The first time
he's a Mormon.
Get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use the
Hivago. Is a Z silent? Is it just Hivago cuck? Or is it with a Z?
Are they only allowed to read books with their eyes?
With their eyes.
It's part of their.
No, they gotta read it in Braille. Even if they can see, they have to use Braille.
But it still can't be erotica. Like, that's so, even if they read it in Braille, it's like a sin.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh, it's because it's erotica.
Probably.
Yeah, her book's erotica.
Did you know you can listen to LRN.FM via our free-to-air satellite channels? We have channels over
nearly
all of North America.
No.
On the air?
Yeah. We've already played it.
I'll play during the commercial.
Wait, which did you download it?
Learn more at sat.
You have the whole book.
So when you say it's a free download, you're talking about it on like on Audible. It's on Audible, right?
Yeah, it's on Audible and it's on iTunes.
So, really? Mm-hmm. And so it's free on iTunes?
No, you have to sign up for a membership or some shit.
That's okay. Yeah, because I got an Audible thing just so I could get my free audiobooks, and I use them up. So now I'm always bummed when people are like, free audiobook. I'm like, oh hell yeah, and it's like.
Oh, you can't get it.
I can't get it because I already used them up.
Well, just go and buy my book and read it.
We're going to come back with this playing into the bumper.
Oh, boy.
Wait, which one is it?
or visit us online at RRB.
I don't know if it plays.
Revolution leader, deputy leader, Dom, sub, seizing political power, climaxing, no sex before marriage, a revolutionary pillar, but God never said no BDSM before marriage. You can have your orgasms, just not your intercourse. And no, no matter how much you whine like a little girl, we won't violate this principle. And we'll try to give you an earth-shattering orgasm.
And if you're listening to the Rebel Love Show, go download my audiobook on audible.com. Let's Use Free Speech to Exalt Revolution BDSM, written by Andrew Bushard, narrated by yours truly, the Rebel Mistress. Go check it out. Download it. Give me 5 stars. Yes, 5 stars. Even if you don't, you know, want to read it, just download it for free.
Yeah, then you guys could have like audio parties where like you invite all your friends and can all listen to it together.
That's pretty kinky.
I know.
Yeah, well, there's some really kinky stuff in there, actually.
Really?
Like, really? Like, it gets really kinky.
Can you tell us?
So, I feel like the kinkiest thing in there is like this poem. It's a book of poetry about BDSM, and so there's this poem about busting balls, ball busting nonstop.
Yeah, that was the best one in there, by the way.
I know. We should have played that one. But anyway.
I don't know why I would have a reaction to that because I don't have balls.
I know.
I just what like, if you see the way really guys like react it? To it,
like getting
anything.
Kicked in the balls. Just like ball busting. Yeah. Some people are really into that
like
shit.
Like brush against something wrong. I'm like, oh my God.
Why wouldn't people be not into it?
I don't know. I feel like it's very painful for the person that I'm when I'm busting their balls. I feel sad. Sorry for them.
You mean metaphorically?
Sure. Anyway, so yeah. Before we left. We're going into Star Wars.
Yes.
And Allie was saying how she disagrees with Rob about the Force. But can I just say, I just feel like the Force is a choice of morality. And I feel like Anakin chose evil and he lost himself in that process. But I still very much like Anakin.
Yes.
Did he really go evil? I mean, come on now. He was trying to save his wife. He was trying to save his kid.
He was trying.
He was defending his own government against an insurrection. The Jedi were trying to do a military coup d'etat of the entire Republic.
I was with Darth Vader up until he saw Padme, and then Padme said, "Hey, you know, I love you, and I really, really want to be with you, but this is kind of crazy, and I can't do that because I'm pregnant." And then he choked her out. Dropped her on the ground, and then she went and had kids without him. And the whole reason he was doing all of this, the whole reason he had did any of this, went to the dark side, is so he could protect her and his unborn children, only to strangle the bitch and like leave her on the thing. Like,
what was it really about?
He only did that because he thought that Obi-Wan. I mean, that she betrayed him and brought Obi-Wan to him.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. That is his pregnant wife. Like, it doesn't matter.
Who brought someone to kill him?
Everyone who, like,
Obi-Wan was clearly not trying to kill him.
She, from Anakin's perspective, she brought Obi-Wan to kill him.
Everyone who does fucked up stuff, like, beats the person they're with, thinks that they're the victim and they had to do it, or they did it for the person's own good. Everyone thinks that. I'm sure Darth Vader thinks that.
Yeah.
But he's wrong. He's on the dark side.
Like, what? He just choked her out, and then she went and had the kids, and then he didn't even ask about her until the end of the show. And, like, I was just like, really? Like, then I felt like it wasn't him anymore. Like, he had did all this stuff for, like, I felt like a good cause. And no matter how many, like, I'm not going to say evil, like, maybe not the best choices, it was still his choice. It was still his choice to, you know, make those choices. And I felt like the Jedi were just so restricting in that way. I don't feel like the Sith was good either, but I feel I'm just such on an individualist perspective. I felt like if it was up to him and he wasn't so pressured or pulled and it had to be like his choice, he probably would have chose the
right
path.
Well, being a Jedi is a voluntary thing, and it would be like if
they're indoctrinated at like very young ages, Alex.
They're forced into it?
Not forced
into it.
They're taken by these men in robes. These robes take these young men.
I didn't see them sit down and say to the little boy, hey, when you become, yes, you want to be a Jedi, but are the rules like commonly understood? Like you want to be a Jedi and now you have to be master to someone else and they, whatever they say goes. And like, I think as long as you want to be a Jedi, yes.
But I think that you can be But they didn't sit him down and tell him that,
you know? And people have natural feelings. Like the moment he fell in love with Padme, they should not have had to hide it. I felt like that was fucked up.
I don't think that it was like the kind of thing where it's like, and here are the rules. You may not. It's like, I think it's like to be a Jedi, they don't want you to have attachments to other people because then
you'll start being fearful
that something might happen to them.
But it's natural to attach.
Or they might leave me or whatever. And you start acting in these ways to try to like preserve what you have in life because you're attached to these people or maybe these things. Maybe they don't want him buying a fancy new sports car that he's obsessed with either.
I mean, I feel
they want him to just be devoted to like selfless and not have, they're not supposed to have possessions and stuff.
But he has powers.
But they have possessions.
Yes, but they didn't grant him his powers. The Force is something that he was born with. So it's not like that they're like saying, oh yes, if you do all these things, we'll give you these. He already has those powers. It's up to you to teach him how to use them for good, not to control him.
But in all honesty, that is where it went wrong. Look at the Jedi and why the Jedi Order fell. The Jedi Order just followed orders. They just did as
blindly.
They were told, following this, you know, this emperor. And then last minute, that's the guy we're actually supposed to kill and go after. Like, you know, I'm sorry, you're fighting this war, and you're commanding this legion of clone arm, this whole clone army that you don't even know how it was created. No questions asked. Oh,
that's
there's
true.
An
they
army.
Did. They
we'll
did
just
do the whole
go along
like,
with it.
Yeah, we just found this planet, erased from the fucking map.
Yeah.
Like where they're making human clones.
And when they find out that they aren't actually in control of anything, they try to take it. That's what the Jedi did. And they lost because, you know, they kind of deserve to lose.
I felt like the Jedi definitely had a play into forcing Anakin over to the dark side. And I feel like that's also why I feel bad for him. I feel like he really was indoctrinated from the start. And it was easy to fall into more indoctrination because they had trained him that way.
Did you notice that, follow
and not ask questions?
Did you notice that Luke Skywalker did not get like the same? It was like he was kind of rogue. He kind of got to do whatever he wanted. He didn't have
that's foreshadowing. Really, he's Kylo Ren.
He didn't really have like a master in the same sense that Obi-Wan.
Yoda was his master.
I mean, yeah, but he was like, "All right, see you, Yoda," and he was like, "No, you need to stay here for your training." He was like, no, I'm not going to do that.
No, yeah, no, he did.
And Yoda didn't come
you.
Around with him places and like do crazy flying shit with him like Obi-Wan. I'm just saying that
yeah,
it's a different kind of relationship. It's like going to your grandpa and being like, show me your coin collection and teach me about life. You know, more
but
like appeasing
was,
him.
Yeah, and
okay.
he was very,
he had information he needed.
He was very compassionate. I did read a theory about Luke Skywalker. And the theory basically was that if we look at Star Wars differently, when Luke confronted Darth Vader and then he didn't kill him and they made up and like he died, like, and then you see Luke looking at Darth Vader like, oh no, I'm sad my father died, but maybe we should look at it as, oh no, my father died, now we can't rule the universe together. That's what he's really sad about, and not like he's sad that his dad died, but he's also sad that his dad died, and he just found out how powerful he was, and now he can't like rule the galaxy as father and son.
It's just so clear to me.
So who's the new Sith Lord?
At
the question.
At the end, when Darth Vader is like, "You were right, Luke. You know, tell them all that you were right. That's where they wanted you to go with it."
Yeah,
Darth Vader's bad. The Jedi
someone's
good.
A Sith.
I'd rather be a Sith than a Jedi.
I'd rather be just have powers and fuck all these names.
Do you still feel like Luke and the princess should be together?
Oh my god, that was ruined for her, by the
way.
That
was ruined for me.
I was so pissed off.
Is it Princess Leia or Princess? Because I heard some people I heard people in the movie be like Leia. I'm like, Leia.
That
right?
was really ruined for me. Like, I really thought that it was their love story whole time.
I got her all the way.
No, it seemed like that.
Yeah.
It seemed like that to me, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. And my mind was blown. Like, I thought that the idea when.
My mind would have been blown.
Han Solo asked Luke, "What do you think about me and the princess?" And Luke was like, "No." That I took that to be like, okay, like Luke's claiming dibs on
Yeah.
Him.
Yeah. Me, too.
That's what I thought.
And then remember when they kissed and Luke was like,
Yes, yeah, and then she would kiss him vindictively to like be like, fuck you, Han Solo, I'm gonna kiss Luke.
Yeah.
And that's what was weird. Like, that's what I thought of when I realized.
Yeah, and I was like, siblings. That was really ruined for me because I love like pregnancy, like in movies. I don't know. I just find
I know what that means.
Like, I love when someone gets pregnant in a movie and we get to watch them have it, like, be pregnant and then have a baby. I don't know. I find that as a high point.
You're hoping Luke and Leia would have kids when you started watching the show?
No, I would have been really excited that Padme got pregnant and had twins. I would have probably cried and everything. Like, no, well, she did. Twins. I know, but it had already been ruined for me, so I was like, yeah. I was just pissed off. I was like, fuck that guy for telling me. He took my happy moment.
She watched New Hope, Empire Strikes Back, and Phantom Menace, and we were about to watch episode two. Maybe we already did watch episode two. I think all that was left. No, it was two and three that was left at the time. And it got ruined. I kept that secret that so Luke and Leia, and even after Empire Strikes Back, she wasn't putting two and two together. She didn't put the two completely together yet.
I heard the episode and you're all like, you're like laughing when she said that. And it was just like, it was a little bit like you were implying that there was something wrong with her saying that. Or like something funny, at least, about her saying that.
Oh, when she said, I
asked him, I was like, what's so funny?
When she said, I want Luke and Princess Leia to be together.
She didn't know yet.
Yeah, I was like, I thought it was going to be like a team. I thought it was going to be like a team Jacob, team Edward thing. And I was like, I am team Luke, man. Luke and Leia, they're perfect. Their names
now,
go together.
Here's the thing, is that... We can talk about it when we get back, unless you want to stop talking about Star Wars.
No, we just bring it back.
But you could be onto something as far as the match is what I was saying. It goes along with my theory.
Okay.
I could see your point of view.
I do want to
raise it at my point of view.
I do want to say one thing. If I'm going to defend the Sith, there's one thing I disagree with what they did. Well, a couple things, multiple things. I think they were justified in wiping out all the younglings, though.
That's fucked up.
Anakin had to do what he had to do.
I don't know how you even say that. That was like the most fucked up part of the movie. I was like, oh my god, kill the
look. It's war. The Jedi Order declared war on the Empire.
So you need to murder kids.
Those kids were already indoctrinated to defend the Force, and they were fought to death.
The part I don't like most about all the movies, and I feel like the most fucked up part, is the human cloning. I feel like I feel like people like downplayed that part. Like, they just have a fucking planet where they're making billions of fucking human clones. Like, and no one's just like, you know, maybe we should go check that out. Like, that's kind of not okay. Like, I don't know. I didn't
clones
like that.
Clones aren't real people, and they weren't.
No. They are real people. Like, and they make them with like deep.
Do you love Twitter?
Super fun.
Sorry about that. I knew it. I thought we were going into it. I was one commercial away.
Okay, and welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were talking about who's a Sith and who's a Jedi. And I think I really like the Force. I like the natural, like, nature part of it. And I really want the Force. I feel like I have it. I don't like the Jedi. I feel like they are way too restrictive. I don't like the Sith because they're fucking evil. Like, they're evil.
The Sith take it a little too far. I mean, yes, Darth Vader was a little willy-nilly with the Death Star. Like, just blow up Alderaan on a whim. Yeah. I get that.
The Sith is evil because I feel like what makes them evil is they have a lust for power. Like, wanting power is wanting power is okay. I feel like once you wanting power becomes lustful, like gluttonous and greedy, like that is what makes it evil. Like, there's a reason they say those are the seven deadly sins, because once you like turn to those, like, there's no coming back. And that's the problem with the Sith. They wanted power to the point where it was lustful. It was greedy. Like, they shouldn't want to bring people back from the dead because it's not their choice.
Well, they don't have any problem with committing aggression.
Yeah, that too. Neither do the Jedi.
But don't the Jedi? I mean, I feel like I might be contradicting like a bunch of stuff that actually happens in there. I don't want to sound stupid, but
no, they're not stupid.
Let's see. I thought that like part of the Jedi thing was that they're kind of like, in a sense, only willing to use the force, or like as some kind of principle of theirs in like self-defense, or to like not intentionally hurt their opponent. They have some kind of like, I bet it's like some kind of, it's like true of a lot of martial arts and stuff.
I mean, they're
think of them as being like, you know, doing karate and shit.
I suppose, but they're
or some kind of
they're peacekeepers. Yes, but I feel like
they're not peacekeepers. They enforce the power of the states over all the citizens of the Galactic Republic. They make sure everyone falls in line. That's what they do.
I mean,
and when they're separatists that say, you know what, no thanks, we're good. What do? They take an entire clone army that just poof magically appeared in their front in front of them. We'll go use these people to go attack this entire other group of people.
I feel like the Jedi definitely weren't nonviolent. I don't feel like there was ever something established where they had a nonviolent philosophy.
They helped like the government. They were like, whatever you guys want.
Yeah. I mean, they were peacekeepers. Like, and I'm saying that in the truly Hunger Games sense. They were peacekeepers. But I felt like the Jedi were no better. Like, it was, they had this power and they were just like using it for the opposite, but still being violent. I don't know. I feel like I like the Force, and I feel like maybe Luke had the right idea. I like Luke. I feel like Luke's idea was, you know, I'm going to just do what I think is right.
Maybe this
he went and he did what he thought was right, and he saved his friends and his dad.
Maybe this whole series is supposed to like bust the whole idea of like good people and versus bad people altogether, because like we're having such trouble being
like pinpointing
figuring
pinpointing
out
what's besides what's bad.
The fact that Rob's like off his rocker being all like pro Sith.
No,
yeah,
no,
like, he's always pro Sith. He's like,
it's really funny.
Well, I think the Sith take it a little too
but
far,
it's interesting.
And you can't you know, tarnish the entire every person.
The
that
Sith are
Sith
smart.
In that galaxy.
The Sith went like they were waiting for this shit. They built a whole planet making clones of humans like 10 years before anyone had a thought about it. So. I mean, I feel like they had really planned ahead, and they were really smart about it. And the Sith Lord kicked Yoda's ass.
Yeah.
Like, he kicked Yoda's ass. So, I mean, I'm Game of Thrones style. Like, if you can get the throne, take it. I feel like the throne was bullshit in the first place. That's why we shouldn't have such concentrated power amongst people.
And watching in the machete order. So, like, from our perspective, watching it like that again, you know, episode 3 rolls around, you know, Darth Sidious just kicks ass. Like, every Jedi that comes after him just, like, knocks him out of the park.
Yeah. And the Jedi went out like pussies.
Yeah, and then literally, the next movie, he's right there in front of Luke Skywalker watching Luke and Darth Vader fight each other. Like, that's literally, like, the next movie. You know, and you see that the literally in a 30-year time span.
Wait, can we pause? Because you said you didn't like the fight scenes. Like...
In the, I'm just saying that, like, in the newer movies, they're all jumping up in the air and, like, meeting in the air and then doing backflips while they hit each other, like, bouncing off the lightsabers. And
but they were
kind
more
of,
I thought they
were
a little too crazy.
I'm just saying
them.
That they went, I'm just like, okay, so this is what a lightsaber fight's like.
Yeah.
And then it seems like, but part of what's funny is that, okay, so it's in the future and these characters are older now. You know, Obi-Wan is older now and
Yoda's super old.
Yeah, and Yoda's super old. And
he's
so
like 900.
When they're fighting in, what is it, the first, one of the first scenes in the, what was the fourth movie?
The fourth movie was A New Hope.
Okay,
with Luke Skywalker.
When they're doing the lightsaber stuff, it looks like they're just like too old to like do it like they used to. You know, they're just like.
Well, maybe that's the case. Maybe that's the case.
I don't know. I mean, it works. It works with the story. It does. It's funny. It's like, well, they're equally shitty now. You know, it's not like, you know, one of them still bounce off the wall.
At one
and the other
point,
one can't
I
do
felt
it.
Like they both got tired. You know, like I felt like there was a scene where like the two people were fighting each other and they both were like, shit, like my back hurts.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, that's the vibe.
I gotta get my lightsaber. Yeah, I felt like that's how most people got away. They just got tired. Like, that's how the fight scenes ended.
I like to imagine that like people when the movie came out were like, oh my God, this is so intense.
And it was intense because those lifesavers.
I'm not looking down on them.
From back
it's just
then, that was
it's just amusing to me. It's like amusing, like when you're looking at like an old payphone or something. It's this is how people used to communicate. I can't believe that.
I don't know. I liked all the Star Wars movies equally.
Even the original Star Wars, it's bad special effects compared to the day is like it still looked good even for now. Like it still looks like
no, it does not look good for now. No, it does not.
I thought it was nice.
Return of the Jedi does.
It's quaint.
Okay,
in a
so
cute
maybe
way.
It's
I think the word you used was cute.
I've been watching like Doctor Who a lot.
That's why everyone's so excited about Star Wars. They're like, oh my God, have you seen Star Wars? It's this new series. It's super cute with the graphics.
Well, I've been watching Doctor Who a lot, and a lot of their, like, the show looks like that, but on purpose. Like, it looks like it takes place in the 70s, but, like, on purpose. And so I guess I was just used to that film style. And I give every, like, I don't know. I don't get why everyone's hating.
I'm glad.
Why is everyone a hater?
I'm glad, as a new person watching it, that you are not judging it based off of these special effects from, like,
I'm not hating on the fact that they didn't have as good. I mean, my thing is, there was more sex, but. If when we watch movies nowadays and go to the theater, some imagination is required for us to get into the movie. We have to,
but not much.
Some imagination is required, and I'm sure in 20 years we'll be like, "What? Be like, wow, this movie just takes too much imagination." Like now, I'm used to doing my virtual reality movies, and it's just like way better.
Yeah.
So I can't believe I watched this shit.
So,
well, actually, we'll think it's awesome and retro, and young people won't get it. They won't get why we watched movies that we watch now.
Yeah,
probably.
Yeah, eventually it's going to be all VR.
They'll think it's silly that they watch it on just a screen.
They'll just close their eyes and they'll be a movie.
Yeah,
just like playing in their head.
So I'm just saying that I understand that when the movie came out, it was like, wow, this is even, they're like showing me things that I've only been able to imagine in my head. And now I can like have a picture to it.
Yeah.
Still for me, I'm just, I grew up with a different caliber of graphics. And so did you, Anne.
Yeah.
So when we see that, and all of us.
Yeah, I thought it was cute.
You too, Rob. And so when we see it, it's like.
I thought it was amazing.
It's like,
well,
I'm just having to use my imagination and figure out what they meant when they put in these shitty graphics. I know what they mean to say.
Yeah. I just thought it was cute. I just took it for what it was and thought it was cute.
As a Star Wars fan, I would say, especially the first movie, that CG stuff was horrible. I hated the CG in one. Like CG one, the CG, the graphics in
it was kind of
episode
cheesy,
one.
Yeah.
It looked like a video game. It didn't look like it was actual.
It looked like a kid's movie.
Yeah.
It looked like a kid's movie.
That was a big gripe with like every Star Wars fan with one.
You guys are just.
And you actually
like to
one.
Calm down.
You just like
you guys just need to calm down.
Yeah, I didn't care for that at all.
I think you guys just need to calm
down.
So
what's your predictions, guys, for
the future?
Yeah,
okay, so we're
Force
doing
Awakens.
Star Wars and Christmas. We're doing Star Wars and Chinese.
I don't
Chinese
have to
food.
Wait a whole goddamn week.
Yeah. So I just wanted
Star
to
Wars.
About the predictions thing. So the thing I was saying about how Anakin is in love with Padme, and that's like his downfall. That's what kind of ends up being his corrupting force, or what at least justifies.
I feel like hiding,
turning to the dark side.
That,
she's like, "Oh my gosh, I had this dream that she's gonna die during childbirth."
Because they have to keep it a fucking secret because of the Jedi. Like, yes, he's having nightmares about that.
Well, maybe that's
because
a bad policy, but I'm saying
should
that
not. That's the whole reason he turns to the dark side, having to hide the fact that he got his own wife pregnant and worrying that she's gonna fucking have to give birth in a cave to keep it from the Jedi to begin with. Well,
you might
have
a point.
More when we come back.
What if the
was that going off on its own, like the microphone? Yeah. That was weird. Like
you. Yeah, mine does.
Liberty
does
activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85%.
The home button on that, if you like triple tap it, like it brings up S Help or whatever. Like it's Samsung version of Google Now. But her home button doesn't work really well. It's like mushy. You like push it hard, so I think it gets stuck, and it thinks you're hitting it. But it's really weird that like that just popped on. As well. Apparently the feds don't have enough foresight to go to rebellovshow.com/live. They actually have to hack into her phone to listen to us
remotely. Turn on the microphone. Hope I don't hear.
With regular social events each week, see what's happening at freekeen.com and get connected with video, audio, free books.
Oh yeah.
I thought the best fight was when Anakin got his ass like handed to him at the end, where he tried to jump up there and he was like, "You underestimate my power," and he just like cuts off his leg. I'm like, "Damn, ice cold." That is a good scene.
You on top of the latest innovations in crypto finance, security, networking, transportation, and gadgetry like drones and 3D printers.
That's the end of Empire Strikes Back.
YouTube and SoundCloud.
Yeah.
And be an early adopter of the future. The Daily Deep Crypt.
Now that you've found the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM, you may want to help expose others to our great programs. To assist you in doing so, you'll find resources at promote.
Yeah, like no fucks given. Yeah, like he got, like he was getting whipped.
Banners for your website, as well as files that will allow you to make your own custom banners and graphics. Visit promote.lrn.fm and help bring new listeners to the Liberty Radio Network. That's promote.lrn.fm.
Yeah. No, but that's the whole theory that why he's the Sith. That moment when he beat Darth Vader's ass. Like, you have to think he realized that. He realized how powerful he was. He just handed Darth Vader's ass to him. Like, tell us what books
we can read. You gotta admit though, Darth Sidious, he had a good run.
Yeah, he did.
He basically went like 60 years.
Darth Sidious was a thug.
Yeah. For a long time too. And he was controlling the entire Jedi Order for years.
Yeah. Before that.
War that he created.
Yeah.
Just so that he could take power.
Man-made factory. Yeah. You gotta give it to Darth Sidious at that point. Like, Yoda was not that smart, you know?
I really want them to make a Star Wars movie based off of a whole series based off Knights of the Old Republic.
What? Knights of the Old Republic? What
yeah, it was a BioWare game. It's where it takes place 4,000 years before the movies, and there's an entire like Sith army, and an entire Sith order, an entire Jedi order, and they're vying for power of the Republic. And it was like Mass Effect, and the choices you made affected storylines. You can literally save the galaxy or take it over at the end. Share the link on social media and let your as a Sith or as a Jedi, like it had a lot of different plot twists.
Download it now free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
The new fourth edition of Healing Our World, the Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level.
That's the last one. References, new cartoons, so
we can give our closing thoughts. You need to say who you think the Sith is in the new movies and why, and then we'll go on to drug liberals, pragmatists,
and environmentalists. To what? Yeah, I was going to ask you how far Stefan Malden has fallen from the tree. I know. Can we bring? I do want to bring this up.
Listen,
you want me to bring it back then?
Oh, no, I'm bringing it back.
Okay.
Well, you guys don't with Star Wars. I don't know anything about Stefan Malden. And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. We're just going to give our final thoughts on this whole Star Wars debacle because it just needs to end here. And I feel like the one question we need to ask
is Stefan Molyneux pro Darth Vader?
Is Stefan Molyneux the new Sith Lord in the new movies?
Would that make Chris Cantwell his apprentice?
Maybe. His young Padawan?
His young Padawan.
Yeah. That's a pretty funny image.
Yeah, they both went to the dark side.
But who is it? Who's the new Sith Lord? We have to like close this up. If Luke's a good guy,
I just thought that
he's not a good guy. He went dark.
The problem is that Anakin was a good guy, and
not for that long. Though
before, maybe we disagree about what we clearly do disagree about what turned Anakin to the dark side and made him into Darth Vader.
It was a Jedi.
But I think that part of the problem, at least as far what the Jedi think, was that it probably had to do with getting attached to Padme and probably getting her pregnant.
At the end of the day, he fucking killed the Darth Sidious. At the end of the day, he killed Darth Sidious for his son. So imagine if he would have got to, you know, I don't know, maybe get a girl knocked up and do the right thing and marry her and not have to keep that a secret and worry about her dying from childbirth.
Okay,
he could have had a normal like life in love with her, which he did when they were in secret, their life wasn't that complicated.
The
Jedi restricting them that pushed him to the dark side.
My only point, I just want to make this point just because I've been trying to make it, is that it might be a problem in some people's eyes if they have this theory that now Luke is very invested in Princess Leia, who also has a force and everything in her, I guess.
And also his new Sith Lord.
That
just them together, brother and sister.
Did you notice that when the thing that made Luke be like, fuck you, dad, was that he was like, yes, you and your sister, I'm going to go after your sister and turn her into a Sith. He was like, uh-uh. And
he loves
his sister. He basically freaked out on
love
Darth
is
Vader
a good
when he said
thing.
That. I'm not saying love is a bad thing. I'm just saying that if you're going to be like, ooh, I'm going to yield this force thing that can like kill you in a second, then maybe if you're super attached to certain things and you're just like, I'll do anything for love for this person, and it's kind of like you'll bend your principles and be corrupted, then maybe you don't want to be yielding the power. You got to choose one or the other.
I don't feel like there should have to be a choice.
Well, I think the Sith take it a little too far, so the Jedi.
They both take it too far. Who's the new Sith Lord?
You can be a good Sith. It's Leia.
No, it's not.
She has the Force. It's like 30 years later. Anything could happen.
Even you guys were justifying, like, oh, he could do all these bad things because he's doing it for his the love of his life and his kid. And it's like, well, exactly. He justifies it too. That's the problem.
Now, here's another thing too. No. I am going to attack.
It's not justifying.
Anyone that supports the light side and the Force and the Jedi. All right. Here's my thing. Darth Vader, you know, killed all those younglings. Just chopping them left and right.
Yeah.
Destroyed entire fucking planets. This blew up Alderaan on a whim because Leia wouldn't, bow down. All right.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, he does one good deed, saves his son, he gets to live forever, comes back to life. You know, he learns the trick of the afterlife. All right, that only a few other Jedi like Qui-Gon Jinn, Obi-Wan, and Yoda even know. And he gets that, and he killed all these people, like all these, and he's rewarded for that. And that's,
he's not rewarded.
He gets.
Anakin didn't do all those things. I'd like to think
he was
reborn into his purer self, like the self before he turned to the dark side.
Now, did Anakin really turn to the dark side, or did Darth Sidious just use a Jedi mind trick on him the whole time?
No, Anakin turned to the dark side. Anakin became Darth Vader, that was a totally
different
person.
Because he did one good
thing, it was like what Luke said.
He deserves the afterlife.
Yeah,
sure. He deserves
that.
Just for that one good deed. All those other things that happened.
You know, Christians believe the same thing.
Are you talking about heaven and hell? For
the Force?
Are you talking
about,
did Darth Vader go to heaven or hell?
No, he did. You seen him at the end of the movie.
He comes, yeah.
Yeah.
When Luke is burning.
He's a ghost.
Yeah, he's a ghost.
Okay, and I just want to point this out. I think I pointed out before with you guys. Isn't it crazy that the ghost that comes back in the old movies looks like Anakin in episode 2? Like,
yeah, that
looks like the same motherfucker.
Yeah.
How do they know that? How do they know who's going to play him?
I think that was the same guy.
No, it might be if it's a re-edit.
Yeah, they probably.
In that actor, but I'm sure it wasn't.
A re-edit?
They re-edited it at the end of the 90s. I think they made another remix like later on. Maybe they didn't.
I don't know.
They made it one
time.
It's
easy
that
must
have been confusing
like
for people who were alive in that time and hadn't seen the new movies.
So,
and were like, who is this kid?
When we're watching the old movies, there's scenes that are in the old movies that we were watching online. Like, I had to point out, like, this scene was not in the original airing of this movie. Like, there's multiple scenes that actually never aired on the original movie going out. And they added those in like, the 25th anniversary or something like that.
Interesting.
Well, I mean, can I just go into, like, a few more theories? Because I feel like the whole Jar Jar Binks thing, though, I don't think it's him. But the only thing with Jar Jar Binks
for
is,
for those listening at home, people think that Jar Jar Binks is
the new Sith Lord.
Interesting theory.
He really did, even though he probably thought he was doing the right thing, because of him, he granted emergency powers to the Chancellor.
He convinced the entire Senate to give him.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
They didn't show us him
just
really.
His hand.
Yeah.
Did they
and
show
that was
him
it.
Speaking?
Yeah,
yeah.
He was speaking
and
in front of the entire Senate.
Yeah. He said, I give him all the power. And then he was responsible for kind of everything that happened after that. But again, they thought they were doing the right thing. You remember the Jedi, the Council, the Senate, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And plus, Jar Jar Binks, it's a little mysterious how he's, like, came to power so fast. Like, you just, in every episode you watch, Jar Jar Binks
is just upgrading his power.
How
long is Jar Jar Binks supposed to live? Like,
I don't know, probably like 100, 200 years.
Yeah.
Yoda was 800.
Like, he was a slave, stolen, like running away or something from his like homeland, and then waves his arm. He's like assistant to Padme, waves his arm. He's all of a fucking sudden a senator. Like,
if Yoda was 800
movies.
Years old, he went downhill fast. Like,
he was 900.
He looked great. He was like whipping up a storm in the new movies.
Yeah, he was.
And then they're like, okay, so Obi-Wan's a little bit older. He's got a lot older. Got gray hair and shit. And Yoda's like
old.
Yoda's like gross.
Yeah,
his eyes are all not even pointing the right direction. I don't know if that was like intentional.
Yeah, towards the end when he was dying,
it
he was like,
great.
No, the
special whole movie. Effects it for just... its time. It was great.
He was sick.
I'm just, I don't know. I guess that was hard. It's like, they wanted to can't get the eyeballs to go the same direction.
They wanted to
I'm sure they'll eat it up. But it's the best shit they've ever seen.
Do you know how many toys Lucas sold of Yoda because of those movies?
Okay, but wait. Back to my Sith Lord story. So I just feel like Jar Jar Binks was suspicious, and they never really explained him a lot. I just seen him advancing in power so rapidly, but not doing shit. Like, and then the whole fight scene where he jumps up and
they
then
just give him power. It was weird. It was like, this guy doesn't come off as a competent person. Why would you just like, hey, Jar Jar Binks, do my job for me?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Why would you do that?
Yeah.
Because that part didn't make sense to me.
Yeah. And like none of the parts made sense. Like he just started getting all this power. And then the one thing he does that's like standoutable is like give all the powers to the Senate. So I feel like there could be something there. I don't feel like
he
his story is.
And
then
he was like commander. He was a general of the Naboo army.
Yeah.
He became
How? You know? Like exactly. When did you see? You seen Jar Jar Binks in one fight scene where he jumped really high.
Yeah,
When he was out there as a commander, he was like,
falling over and stuff. And I was just like,
go back to Empire Strikes Back and look at Yoda when he's talking to Luke before he came out as being a Jedi Master. He acted like a buffoon and a crazy person. All right. And Luke just thought of him as that thing.
Yeah.
He didn't even think of him that was like some Jedi, like, you know.
Yeah.
He was kind of like the monkey from The Lion King, you know?
Yeah.
Like, kind of crazy.
But who is to say that Jar Jar Binks isn't doing the exact same thing?
That's the only reason I feel like he probably could, because I don't feel like his story is explained well enough, but maybe I'm overthinking it. But we're about to go. Yeah. So you got any theories? Or where can we find you?
Yeah, where's any theories that where we can find you, Allie?
I'll be typing up my new theories on Star Wars on my blog. No. So I guess definitely people should check out AllieHapens.com when I put content up there.
I know. When are you going to start a podcast?
Sometime in the future, probably.
Okay.
That's speculative.
Yeah, you need to.
Every time he sees you, he's going to ask you now.
Yeah, when's the podcast coming? When's the radio show? When's the YouTube show? All right, and
You can be on Flaming Freedom with me sometimes. That'd By the way, I'm
news.
I'm
come
doing
on now,
Flaming Freedom every Thursday night at 10.
The Rebel Mistress is taking over Flaming Freedom.
I'm not taking over. I'm just filling in temporary shoes until Derek gets back from all the Guays, Paraguays. I don't know where he is. But anyway, go like my page, The Rebel Mistress. Go download my book on Audible.com.
And you can find the Rebel Love Show at rebelloveshow.com. Go subscribe to us on YouTube, Stitcher, iTunes, all that crazy shit. All right. Peace, guys.
Peace.
Peace.